Today we'll look into details of another family or subfamily called as Mimosoidea. And coming to the classification or systematic position, it belongs to Dicotyledonae, Polypetalae, Calciflorae, order Rosales, and family Mimosaceae. Family Mimosaceae. So this is the smallest family among the three subfamilies of Leguminaceae. We have already said that Leguminaceae is subdivided into, or it is divided into subfamilies like Fabaceae, Cisalpinaceae, and Mimosaceae, or they may be also called as Papilionoidea, Cisalpinoidea, and Mimosoidea. Okay, among these three, this is the smallest one. This family is the smallest among these three subfamilies. Okay, then coming to family details or generic details, this family is comprised of, or it has about 58 genera and 2,800 species. And these members or these plants are distributed mainly in tropical and subtropical regions. They are present in tropical as well as subtropical regions. And they are worldwide in distribution, right? Ushnamandala prantalalo ekkuga ivi vyapinchi untai. So coming to details of these of the family members in India. In India, 15 genera and 72 species have been reported till now. And they are mostly found in Himalayas. Okay. Himalayas and Western Peninsular region. They are present or they are seen in Himalayan regions and Western Peninsular regions of India. Then coming to the familiar plants or important plants of this family, Mimosaceae or Mimosoidea. This is the list, like Acacia catachu, which is called as catachu or kasu. Mamulga palaturlalo adi tintaru kada, tamalapaku aku vakka esukoni tintaru kada. Avuna andulo kasu ani estaru, koncham red color lo untadi, podi laantidi. అవునా ఆ చెట్టు అది కాసు దెన్ అకేషియా చుండ్రా దెన్ అకేషియా అరబికా విచ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ నల్ల తుమ్మ ఆర్ బబూల్ అకేషియా సైన్యుయేటా షికాకాయ్ ఓకే అకేషియా ల్యూకోఫ్లియా సఫేద్ బబూల్ తెల్ల తుమ్మ అకేషియా మెలనో మెలాన్జైలాన్ బ్లాక్ వుడ్ ఆస్ట్రేలియన్ తుమ్మ అకేషియా సెనగల్ అకేషియా Senegal, gum arabic, Albizia lebac, Sirisha chettu, Albizia odoratissima, fragrant Albizia, then Enterolobium saman, Nidra ganneru antunnaru, Pithecolobium dulci, Seema chinta, Mimosa pudica, which is called as Tashminot plant, Telugulo aithe Atipatti antunnam, ledha Lajjavati ani pilustam, Prosopis cinerea, Prosopis spicigera, జమ్మి చెట్టు అంటారు. దసరా రోజు జమ్మి ఆకులు ఇస్తారు కదా, అవునా? దసరా పండగ రోజు జమ్మి ఆకులను ఇస్తూ ఉంటారు. చిన్న 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 ఆకులు ఉన్నటువంటిది ఆ జమ్మి చెట్టు. ఇది ప్రోజోపిస్ చిలెన్సిస్ ఆర్ ప్రోజోపిస్ జూలిఫెరా, సర్కార్ తుమ్మ అంటాం. ఓకే, జైలియా జైలోకార్ప, చెన్నంగి. ఈ చెన్నంగి ఆకులని చెన్నంగి కాయలను కూడా వెజిటేబుల్స్ లాగా తీసుకుంటూ ఉంటారు కొన్ని కొన్ని ఏరియాస్లో, రైట్? These are the list of familiar plants or plants which come across in our day-to-day life. Then coming to habit and habitat, mostly they are xerophytes, and that means xerophytes means these are the plants which grow where water scarcity is seen, or in the on the soil surfaces where water scarcity is observed. In those areas only these plants are grown. They are thorny, that means they produce some thorn-like outgrowths, appendages. Okay, then come, and few are mesophytes. And Neptunia, a plant called Neptunia oleracea. This is a hydrophyte plant which grows in water. Then coming to the habitat, Mimosa is a herb. Touch me not plant antunam, Atipatti plant. This is a herb. Then Acacia, this is a shrub. And Entrolobium, Zylia, Albicia, Rosopis. Okay, all these are Acacia, Catachu. All these plants are trees. And Entera Persieta, or Entera Scandens. This is a plant which is woody climber. It is very specific. It is a woody climber like jasmine. Then Acacia sinuata is a small prickly shrub. These are the details of habit and habitat. Then coming to vegetative characters, here the root system is taproot system because it belongs to dicotyledonae, or it's a member of dicotyledons. The root system is taproot system. Coming to the stem details, the stems of this family are aerial. They are erect, cylindrical. They are hard, woody. Woody in trees. That means the trees, plants which grow as trees, they show secondary growth. Plants evaithe vrukshaluga maha vrukshaluga perugutuntayi avanni kuda dvitiya kaanda vruddhini jarugutu untayi. So daruyuta kaandalu anevi kanipistu untayi. That's why they are hard and woody in trees, because they show secondary growth. In some examples, we have said that climbers are also seen. So these climbers are twining and they are angular. And in few species, mostly Acacia species, spines are produced on the stem region. Then coming to the leaf details, the leaves which are present in this family, Mimosaceae or Mimosoideae, they are alternately arranged, or they show alternate phyllotaxy, and a specific identification characteristic feature is observed, which is pulvinous leaf base, presence of pulvinous leaf base. Okay, then we'll see that diagram here. See, can you see this image? Can you see this image? Say yes or no. See, this is a pulvinous leaf base which is present here. The base of the leaf, this is the petiole and this is the lamina, and at base of the petiole, or what do you call, stalk of the leaf stalk, is somewhat bulged, or it is swollen. So this swollen part, if the leaf is having a swollen leaf base, then it is described as pulvinous leaf base. This is a common feature which is present in these three members, Papilionoideae, Cisalpinaceae, Cisalpinoideae, and Mimosoideae. This is a common feature which is present in all the three subfamilies, or all the three families, like Fabaceae, Cisalpinaceae, and Mimosaceae. Okay, then stipules are present. So since stipules are present, we are calling it to be stipulate. And here, in case of Acacia and Prosopis, stipules are modified into spines. Stipules which are present, okay, at the base of the leaf, or the base of the leaf base or petiole, the stipules which are present, leaf appendages which are present, they are modified into spines in case of Acacia and Prosopis. I'll show all those images. Let me finish first Acacia and Prosopis. One second. Can you see this?
Mm-hmm.
can you see spine like structures here? This is prosopis. This is prosopis twig. Here you can see some spine like structures. Can you see them? These are the stipules which are modified into minute spine like structures. Okay. I'll show if it is clear in other cases. Yeah. In acacia also we have seen that we have said that stipules which are present are modified into small spines. Can you see this clearly? These are the modified spines. These are the leaf appendages, stipules, and these stipules which are present in acacia, they are modified into horn-like structures or spiny structures. Okay. Kanipistunna amma image?
Yes, ma'am.
ఇదిగోండి కనిపిస్తున్నాయా స్పైన్ లైక్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్ లీఫ్ అపెండేజెస్ ఉన్నాయి స్టిప్యూల్స్ అంటున్నాము ఈ స్టిప్యూల్స్ ఏంటి అంటే లీఫ్ అపెండేజెస్ అంటున్నాము ఈ లీఫ్ అపెండేజెస్ మోడిఫై అవుతూ ఉన్నాయి దేనిలాగా అంటే స్పైన్స్ లాగా మోడిఫై అయ్యాయి సో స్పైన్ లైక్ స్టిప్యూల్స్ స్పైనీ స్టిప్యూల్స్ ఆర్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ అకేషియా అండ్ ప్రోసోపిస్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఇమేజెస్ దెన్ other characteristic features. Then in Acacia spirocephala, this is another species of acacia where within the spines ants reside or ants live inside the spines of Acacia spirocephala. Ants, they live inside the spines of Acacia spirocephala plant. So such spines are called as myrmicophilous spines. Okay, ee cheemalu chinna chinna cheemalu laanti evaithe unnayo avi aa spines lopala nivasa nerparchukuntu untayi. So atlanti spines ni myrmicophilous spines antunnam. Ee plant lo untundi itlanti modification ante Acacia spirocephala ane plant lo ganipistundi. Okay, then coming to leaves. Leaves are generally bipinnately compound or it may be unipinnately compound in case of Pithecolobium dulci. Seema chinta antunnam kada, aa seema chintalo the leaves are unipinnately compound. Okay, in case of Acacia melanoxylon, in Acacia melanoxylon, petiole is flattened into a phyllode where the leaflets which are present are completely suppressed. Leaflets which are present are completely suppressed or they are reduced so that the function of the leaves is taken up by or the function of leaflets is taken up by the petiole, modified petiole. So this modified petiole is expanded into a flattened structure called phyllode to perform photosynthesis. This is observed in case of Acacia melanoxylon. Okay, in case of Mimosa pudica and Neptunia oleracea, Mimosa pudica and Neptunia oleracea, these are the two plants which show sensitivity to touch. Muttukunte muchukopothu unde idi chusi untaru mana college lo kuda kanapadthu undedi avuna atipatti antunnam touch me not plant antam ee plant leaves ni जस्ट इला टे सेंसिटिविटी की टच सेंसिटिविटी उबटी अभी क्लोज उठाई सो अला मूवेंट्स सीस्मोनास्टिक मूवेंट्स अंटुन्नाम टू प्लांट्स की कंपिस्तुंटे माइमोजा पूडिका इज अ टेरेस्ट्रियल प्लांट वेरास नेप्टूनिया ओलरेसिया इज अ एक्वाटिक प्लांट अभी नीलल्लो पेरुगुतू नीलल्लो उंडेटटुवंटि टच मी नॉट प्लांट अदि नेप्टूनिया ओलरेसिया ओके माइमोजा पूडिका अनेदि टेरेस्ट्रियल हैबिटेट्स लो पेरिगेटटुवंटि प्लांट So leaves, any special feature ni kaligi unnai antunnamu touch sensitivity ni ledha seismonastic movements ni chupistu untai. This is a special feature, special characteristic feature of these two plants. Then moving to floral characters. Here, the inflorescence is always axillary in nature. They grow, or the inflorescence, they grow in the axils of the leaves. Terminal inflorescence అనేది కనిపించదు. అగ్రభాగాలలో ఎక్కడ కూడా inflorescence అనేది కనిపించదు. ఎక్కడ పెరుగుతుంది అని అడిగితే these inflorescence they appear or they grow in the axils of the leaves. పత్ర గ్రీవాలలో పెరుగుతూ ఉంటుంది. పత్ర గ్రీవాలలో ఈ inflorescence అనేది పుష్పాలు అనేవి ఏర్పడుతూ ఉంటాయి. Right? Then mostly the inflorescence is globose cymose heads. Type of inflorescence which is observed in case of Mimosaceae or Mimosoideae is globose cymose head inflorescence. This type of inflorescence is seen in Mimosa pudica, acacia species, and Albicia plants. And in case of Prosopis spicigera, tumma chettlu antunnam kada, veetilo elongated spikes anevi kanipistunte. Elongated spike inflorescence anevi kanipistu unte, right? In Adenanthera we can see clustered racemose inflorescence. Then coming to flower details, the flowers are bracteate, they are e-bracteolate, they are pedicellate in case of Adenanthera, because in Adenanthera we have observed the inflorescence called as racemose inflorescence, whereas in others we have observed the inflorescence to be a spike. Okay, then in Mimosa it is sessile, that means pedicels are absent. In Albicia, subsessile nature of flower is observed, and the flowers are very small and they are bisexual, that means two reproductive units are present within the flower. They are actinomorphic in nature, that means they can be cut into two equal halves in any place. If the flower is cut into two equal halves, if it is cut in any plane, it can be divided into two equal halves. So such characteristic feature is described as actinomorphic feature or character. And the flower is perigynous, it is described to be perigynous, that means half inferior and half superior ovary is observed. That means saucer-shaped thalamus is present, or saucer-shaped floral disc is present. One second,